Hey guys, what's up? I want to talk about some really cool news that I just saw on one of the videos of IGN. Sorry, not IGN. Actually, it was Game Ranks. Sorry. It was by that guy named Jake from Game Ranks. Okay. So what he said was there have been already this name is popping up lately, and this name is none other than, this word is none other than PS5. Okay, so PS5 has been brought up lately by a lot of developers and a lot of people who are making games and stuff. So actually PS5 is going to be totally mind-blowing. Okay, it's going to be something unimaginable, you know, according to Sony and according to all the developers. What they are trying to do is make open world games where NPCs in the open world will have their own lives, okay, in the game. Okay, they will also have things going on. Okay, the open world will be alive, you know, it will feel alive. Whatever you do in the open world, it would affect the whole world. Okay, it would affect the whole game world. Okay, whatever you're doing, any action that you're carrying out in the game world, you know, suppose you're hitting someone, if you're like hitting someone, then you're gonna, you know, face consequences. You know, it's gonna be like the real world. It's going to be, if in the real world, if you hit somebody, if you hit somebody or kill somebody in the real world, then you are gonna pay for it, right? You're gonna face the consequences. Just like, you know, same way, you know, there are gonna be different stories in the game world where if you do something, it's gonna affect the entire place. If you like kill a dragon, then the entire world is going to act like, you know, it's gonna act realistic. You know, the entire world is going to be like, oh, that guy killed a dragon in that place. Okay, suppose you are a guy from Morrowind. Okay, you're living in Morrowind and you're going to Cyrodiil. Okay, suppose a dragon has attacked the Imperial City in Cyrodiil. So you're living in Morrowind, so you're going from Morrowind to Cyrodiil to slay that dragon. Okay, suppose, okay, just imagine. So if you're going there and if you're slaying that dragon, then everybody is going to act, you know, they are going to hype over you. Okay, you're going to be like, they are going to be, oh, they're going to act realistic. They are not going to act like, you know, the normal game NPCs, you know, like how we see in games nowadays. They are not going to act robotic. They are going to feel alive. They are going to seem alive. It will feel as if you are living in some kind of a matrix kind of virtual world, okay? As if, you know, the developers are going to add more depth to the game, okay? There's going to be depth in the molecular level, okay? That's how powerful the game engine of PS5 is going to be. So open world games, future of open world games is bright in PS5. Okay, I don't know what Bethesda will do. Bethesda are going to make the same old shit. Okay, I'm not saying the games are bad, the games are really great. I didn't like Fallout 4, okay, but overall the games are nice, okay, but I think they are not going to add more depth. They are already removing much of the depth in the games. Okay, I don't think they are going to increase any depth in the games, in their games. They are going to remove more depth from their games. Okay, that's what I think about Bethesda. I hope they change their mindset. I hope, if you're listening, Mr. Todd Howard, please change your mindset. Okay, make more complicated depthful games. Okay, make games like, you know, it has to have a lot of depth. And and other developers, I think CD Projekt Red, you know, the developer of Witcher. Yeah, I think they are going to do a great job in future. They are already going to make this. They have already started development on a new sci-fi game, Cyberpunk 2077 something. Sorry if I'm saying the wrong name. I think it's Cyberpunk 2077, right? Yeah, it looks nice, the trailer. Let's see. I think their future is bright. Square Enix future is quite bright. Okay, I mean they just keep on changing their shit, you know. Every other Final Fantasy game they are going to do something different. If they are making a great Final Fantasy game right now, they are going to make a shitty Final Fantasy game tomorrow, and then again they are going to make something right, and then again they are going to make something wrong. You know, that's how their track record is. Recently they're making one good game, then they're making two bad games, then they're making one great game, then they're making one ugly game, then they're making one shitty game, then they're making one great and awesome game. You know, it's fluctuating. So I don't know about Square Enix, but their graphics engine is going to like be awesomest in the whole world, okay? And I think they're going to make there have been already rumors about Final Fantasy Type 1, the sequel to Final Fantasy Type 0. So if they make Type 1 for PS5, then it's going to be really great. I hope they make Final Fantasy 12 remake soon, okay? I just can't wait for it. I mean, I love Final Fantasy 12. I hope they remaster it, you know, for the PC as well. Final Fantasy 10 and 10-2 HD remaster wasn't released for PC. It was only released for the console. I think it was for the PS3 only. Anyways, so the future for open world games is bright. And you know, that's it. You know, PS5 is gonna rock. I don't know how the future of you know, PC gamers, you know, myself included, we have to, you know, upgrade our shit, okay? If you want to play games in future, we have to upgrade our shit like hell, okay? So we really need to match up to the console peasants. No offense. I was just joking. We are all gamers, right? So at the end of the day, we are all gamers, okay? It doesn't matter if you are a PC gamer or a console gamer or whatever, okay? At the end of the day, we are all gamers. We all love to shoot aliens. We all love to, you know, summon Ramu, Bahamut, and Shiva in the Final Fantasy games. You know, we all love to do all that shit. At the end of the day, we are all gamers, okay? So, take care. Aerith died. And I'm so fucking pissed off at Sephiroth for killing her. So it's really sad. You know, I felt really sad. I couldn't sleep last night. I was thinking about it. Really sad. Yeah. Okay then. Bye. Take care.